However, it's going to be a great evening. I just want to thank, right off the bat, thank the Sally D'Arcangelo and Sally Heaney, who conceived this idea and put it together. And also, both staff, the Auburn Eaton Family Services staff, and the staff here, and the students, and the parents, and everybody at the studio. A little bit about Auburn Eaton Family Services, and I don't want to get into a lot, because we're having a very upbeat evening. But as many of you know, we are a social service agency here in Auburn, and we do fundraising to support most of our services. We have a food pantry, we do counseling, we have after-school programs and summer programs, and many other things to help families who are in crisis and in need. And it's never been more important than it is now with the economy the way it is. So we are looking forward to a wonderful evening tonight. We want you to keep Auburn Youth and Family Services in your mind, not just tonight, but always. We have lots of wonderful events throughout the year to raise money. With that, I would like to introduce a serious man who is going to be the MC for the evening. And yes, you can see how solemn he is. He's very. But Mr. Joe Hurley is from Auburn High School. He's a basketball coach. He is a teacher at Auburn High, and he is a terrific, fun person, and we're happy to have him here at the RMC. So with that, I give you.
Thank you, sir. Are you guys ready to have a great time? That's awesome. That's awesome. Listen, I want to thank the Double Sallys for asking me to volunteer and give up my Saturday night. They were very, very persuasive. They said I could have anything I wanted, like a tuxedo. Who wouldn't want to be in a tuxedo on a Saturday night? I was disappointed that I didn't get a chance to dance tonight, though. I would love to compete against Rocco. I was originally scheduled to be in the performance, and believe it or not, I was going to be dancing with Maria Osmond. And we had a serious accident during our rehearsals. We were going through a lift, and she had me up there. Evidently, your elbow gave way. She doesn't need the ultrasound system anymore. She lost about 40 pounds that night immediately. So she won't be with us. She's in Utah tonight with the rest of the Osmond doing their teeth. A couple things. A few little ground rules here. I know that this is a crowded room, and I know some of you have you get very warm in an environment like this, and I know some of you who have like one red blood cell, you're freezing. Okay, so we will be selling wraps out in the hall. Actually, they're pelts, but they will be available for you. It's a fundraiser. As far as the course of the evening goes, let me tell you a few things. We do have some food left. We do have a bar outside there. We do have the Chinese auction that will be going on, an intermission. We will take an intermission. It'll be about 20, 25 minutes long. If anyone has to go to the bathroom, this is how we're going to do this.
Sounds like a cheat.
Over 80, stay where you are. No one's going to know. It's expected. We have two. I was too late, wasn't I? Okay. We have two restrooms. They'll probably be for the women. Guys, if you go up the door where we came in, you'll notice across the parking lot there's like a little boat ramp. Point yourselves toward the water. Do not point yourselves to the left, because that's our smoking area. For those of you who parked your car with the valet tonight, I want to thank the valet. Sadly, the valet couldn't be here tonight. That's a ripoff couple out there. Your pass is currently being packed downtown Worcester near Union Station with the keys in them. Okay, heck with this now. Listen, so throughout the evening, I'll make a few comments about the dancers. I want you to know, though, that this is supposed to be a fun evening. I want you to know that we have only 50% professionals here tonight. The other 50% have loved ones here rooting for them. And no matter how bad they do, we're still going to love them. This is a fun event. It's not a matter of who wins or who loses. Okay, because everyone's going to be a winner tonight. Someone will get the new car, but besides that, Auburn Youth and Family Services is the winner tonight. Is the winner tonight, and that's all. So we're going to try and make this similar to the way they do it on TV, except I didn't get the pretty co-host. I brought my wife, but she was so nervous, I just left her in the car. The good news is she has no concept of time. I told her it'll only be a couple of minutes. But I think leaving the window down is important for her. I can take you see you get all dressed up and sit out there. But anyways, who knows? Maybe she'll buy a motorcycle while she's looking in that window. Okay, we have judges. These judges are not highly trained, but they are, like everything else, volunteers. And they have given up their Saturday evening to help support Auburn Youth and Family Services. They're going to do the very best they can. They're going to be using very stringent criteria tonight. Dance steps, how they look, height. It's a poll for us. Anyways, I said I would say nothing about him until later. I do not want you to make fun of the lips in his shoes, so. Okay, now, let me introduce the judges. I'm not going to read their bios because you have them. I tried to memorize them, but quite frankly, their legs are pretty boring. So, I'm going to make a few things up. I think it's much more interesting that way. Our first judge, Dr. Mary Ellen Brunel. When she left pornography, No, I'm just kidding. She's actually my boss. Dr. Brunel has been a breath of fresh air to the Auburn school system, let me tell you. She has been with the Auburn system for a very long period of time. You're not allowed to tell how many years, but it's more than 10. She received her doctorate from Boston College, and after she received it, she had the opportunity to come back to Auburn and run our system. And I gotta tell you, since she's been at the helm, good things have really been happening in town. I truly don't think I saved my job. However, that is true. And I got to tell you also, superintendent is an awful lot of paperwork, it's an awful lot of meetings, it's an awful lot of time. But being a coach, being a basketball coach, during this time of year, I actually saw her when I was leaving practice one day, sitting in the gym watching a middle school basketball game when there were only like five or six parents there. And there she was with a huge tub of popcorn. There she was cheering the kids on. She's at every event. So, it's great to have you here, my ex-boss. Our next judge is Officer Brian Kennedy. I have nothing really to say about him, except he's probably given every one of us a ticket at one time or another. He's an Auburn High grad. As you watch him walk in, you can see that he's not a dancer. I'm just making things up. The role is up, man, okay? He does have his vest on tonight on the knee, just in case Rocco doesn't like the decision. Because he might be connected, you never know. Next judge. And I'll be very nice to this young lady. This is Ellen Gabriel, Town Clerk, Town of Auburn. Ellen has devoted over 25 years to the Town of Auburn, working for the Town of Auburn, which is basically 90% of her life. She has been in the Town of Auburn. Okay, so Ellen, I'm going to be nice to you right now. We'll see how you vote, and then we'll talk. Next, and this is the person we don't want here with all these chairs, but we have our... And for those of you who are smoking... Just keep the butt down low, okay? We have the Fire Chief, Mr. William Wynon, here. He's been with the Fire Department for 26 years. 26 years. So all these people have a huge Auburn connection. They've given up their Saturday nights to be here and to judge these fine contestants as best they possibly can. So we would like you to stand for the entire evening, if that's okay with you. There's no national anthem or anything here. You can sit down now. Welcome. I just want you to feel comfortable. We have pencils for you. They're not too sharp. Okay, I hope you had a nice night. We'll see you. Now, I'm going to try and remember who the first couple is. I know who it is. I know who it is. I just forget the dance. So, our first couple tonight is Senator Mike Moore and his partner, Kim Harmon. Night for votes, man, let me tell you. I think he's better looking than Scott Brown myself. I gotta wait until Cosmo comes out, though. I don't know. We'll see where they put the staple. Okay. Okay. Mike is from Milford. He's married, he has several children. He's our state senator. Very good to this region, very active, and he's given up his Saturday night to come and dance. When asked if he'd ever danced before, he said no, but he's willing to try anything. He's at least once. Kim Harmon, I met last year for the first time, okay, at a health conference, and she was wearing the same outfit. I'm sorry. Where that came from. Lord, I apologize. Okay, now, Kim is hugely active in the Town of Auburn. She's the CEO of her own company, or a healthcare company. My students have had the opportunity to work with Kim in a number of areas. She had another big health fair coming up, I think, up at Holy Cross. And she's given tons of time and energy to not only rehearsing for tonight, but to the Town of Auburn. So, doing a cha-cha to start this evening off. And this cha-cha is incredibly good for a politician, because when I read it the first time, I thought it said, lips don't lie. But, not bad, huh? Hips don't lie. Let's hear it.
Okay.
My assistant assistants over here. Thank you. Okay, our next dance is Mr. Mike Wade and Miss Sally Heaney. Mike has been involved in the town of Auburn for more than 30 years. He owns the Motorsports International, so if anyone needs a motorcycle or anything, you get home tonight because your cars are long gone. Okay, he's the guy to see. Sally, I've known Sally for a very long time. She's an Auburn High School grad. Her kids came through Auburn High School. We paddled the way through or all the way through. I don't mean they left, I mean didn't graduate. They obviously graduated from high school, but one might have graduated from Cantasco. See? Jump on me, man. Okay. All great kids. I haven't met the youngest one yet. She's in the car with my wife. Okay, now. But I've known Sally. I've had so many students that have come here that have grown as individuals, not just in the dancing area, but in the personal area. She does a great job not only molding young dancers, but molding young citizens. And for her, she teaches them a sense of responsibility, hard work, team play. It is amazing how the kids at our school, anyways, go out of their way to make sure they get to their dance. Their dance becomes so, so important to them. And she, as we said earlier, is instrumental in making tonight happen. Okay, so she has choreographed this waltz this evening. Okay, that Mike and she are going to be doing, and it gives me great pleasure. And they've never rehearsed, I should tell you. Okay? You don't see them, but they're like these green things. That's what they're going to step on. Okay? They're going to do a beautiful waltz for you tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike and Sally.
And then you say hello. And I can hardly speak. My heart is beating slow, and anyone can tell. You think you know me well.
How did you enjoy this?
I don't
Thanks, Mike. Okay, good. He's speechless. He wants to get out of Holly and ride, man. Sorry, we'll try this again. I'll just go.
No, it was fine. Very, very, very nervous, but it was very good. Thank you.
He did a nice job, real nice job. Sally, I know you were nervous. And it's the first time you've really had to do anything like this, I know that. And you know, it's really nice to see these things up close. I didn't know how those things stayed on, that's nice. Okay. Sally, tell us about your experience with Mike on the dance floor.
It has been just so much fun dancing, but I do, you know, this kind of makes me giggle. When I ordered my dress, I said, Michael, we have to practice it. I go, why do we have to practice it? And I said, no, I said, we really think we have to. We got tied up in these. It was over the head. I got tied up. I said, no, we really need to practice it. But it's been so much fun. It really has this whole event has been so much fun.
The judges have to say, shall we? No, it's all good. It's all good. Don't worry about it. I have no idea. Okay, sorry.
Well, I particularly like the cross steps that you did. I thought they were really right on, and I really enjoyed your performance. Thank you.
You know those cross steps?
Absolutely.
Yeah. This is our Lisa Perry. Yes, I guess so. She's using like dance terms. It's pretty good.
There's a rumor going around that I might be dancing next year, and I want you for my partner.
Oh, geez. It's going to be hard to get Mike, you know, to give up dancing after tonight. Right on.
If you were nervous, you didn't look it. It was elegant, really beautiful. It was like you were just floating across the dance floor. So congratulations. Great.
Okay, now.
Practice paid off. I didn't notice any of the cross steps, but I did notice you didn't get tied up in the costume. Very good.
Now a big hand for our second couple of the night. Nice job. Our next couple this evening doing a rumba. They wanted to do the lambada, the forbidden dance. But Paul already done that before, so he wanted a different dance tonight. Sarah Nugent and Paul Frost, ladies and gentlemen. Sarah's a dance instructor here, student, right? Biology major somewhere, right? Clock? Sarah, remember that? That's going bio. We're on the same link, right? Okay, I feel the chemistry. Okay. Paul, I'm not going to say anything until you're done. I know you're focused. Okay? You're focused. I know how hard you've worked for this. He's a state rep, and I'll tell you, he's at our school more than I am. Okay. I think he's a student, but this guy has supported every activity at Auburn High. Every activity. And this is no slight to anyone else, but no one has put more, no elected official, state elected official, because Mike's still pretty young, has put more time into the Auburn school system than Paul Frost. Further ado before he forgets the steps. Let's watch a rumba. Okay.
She wants to be. I put a note on her and eventually she convinced me to do it. But Sally, thank you for doing that. And I want to thank Sarah especially, and Helene, who's already been introduced. When I showed up to that first lesson that was delayed due to death in my family, and we had several delays for the death in Helene's family and Sarah's, but we were able to come together as a team and get it accomplished. But when I went to that first lesson, I felt completely out of my element and truly uncomfortable and really didn't want to be there. But I knew it was for the good cause. I love Auburn Youth and Family Services. And these two individuals helped me, and especially Sarah. I mean, this whole dance was all her, really. And I want you to give her a big round of applause. If it wasn't for Sarah, I'd be on this track right now. So thank you very much.
Nice job, Paul. And I can take it, really, I can. And I know which carriage you are, so don't worry about it. So let's see what the judges have to say. We'll mix it up a little bit.
Well, you didn't look nervous, and I'll tell you, you made tremendous progress. I thought that was red hot. Excellent job.
Very nice. Very nice comment. A little political pressure going on here now. Could be cutbacks in the police department. That's right. Here we go.
All right. Here goes my best Bruno. Paul, it's not frosty in here. That was one hot rumba.
Safe too, right? I know. That's right, right? Whatever you gotta do, man.
Paul, I've seen some fancy footwork come out of the State House over the years. But that was the best.
Well, I agree that the basic was right on. And the turns were just the icing on the cake. You did a great job.
Big round of applause for an awesome cover. Awesome cover. Nice job. Are you guys having a good time or what? This is awesome. These guys are like good. They're good. The judges are going to have a really hard time. It's really going to depend on payouts, gifts, political pressure. Our final couple before intermission. Our final couple before intermission is Mr. Rocco Morano. A little closer if you want. Good. Oh, there they are. They're ready. You know what? I saw Rocco shopping in that outfit just the other day. Rocco has obviously been very active in the education here in Auburn, a former teacher and principal here in the Auburn Public Schools. Still very, very supportive of all of the Auburn activities at the high school. I see making games and everything. Not in that outfit, however. He had the privilege of being Heather's teacher many years ago. Principal, I'm sorry, not teacher, principal. Sorry. Okay. Who'd want to be a teacher? Okay, now, Heather Auburn High grad, unbelievable dancer. graduated from college in Pennsylvania for dance. Actually, was in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, right? She teaches here now with her mom at the studio. Okay, and when it was time to pick someone for her to dance with, we had to find someone who would have the capability of following her. And believe me, we looked everywhere. We couldn't find anyone. Fortunately for us, Rocco was available. He's brought about 225 of his closest friends here tonight. Perspective here. Okay. We're going to see a jitterbug, and for those of you don't know what a jitterbug is, it's not an insect. This is pretty fast dance. Pretty fast dance. So, are you ready, Rocco?
Ready.
Okay. Heather, you ready? Let's do this.
Thank you.
take this time and thank Sally D'Arcangelo and Sally, my mom. I just think that Auburn is the luckiest town to have these two women working for them, especially the parents. I know that the two of them pour their hearts and their souls into what they do, into their jobs, which is working for the kids, and everything that they do is for the kids. And I just hope that someday that I can grow up to be as great of a woman as they are. Thank you, guys.
That was nice. That was very nice. And after the show, I understand that the two of you are going to get on a school bus and do some coloring. I'm not certain, but I mean, I heard that through the grapevine. Okay, let's see what the judges have to say about the jitterbug. Ellen, why don't we start with you, because I could see your head flopping at me. You were gone. A couple people over here were getting ready to rip their bras off. I could see that. You were, weren't you, back there? I see you, girl. You know. I thought it was Tom Jones.
Well, I thought the steps were absolutely great. Your energy was wonderful. I enjoyed it tremendously. Thank you.
Incredible energy. Obviously, the A on your sweater stands for awesome. Now that you guys are done, I can put the defibrillator back in my car.
Don't put the oxygen away. Okay, Mary Ellen.
Rocco, I always knew you had it in you, but it came out in a great way tonight. And honestly, your energy was tremendous, and Fonzie, you look really cool.
Area. First a Republican gets elected, and now we gotta give compliments to a Yankee fan. Oh, that changed everybody's tune, didn't it? Rocco, awesome job.
Big round of applause for Rocco. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been a great first half. Unbelievable. Before we get started, though, we still we have a couple of housekeeping things to do. If you haven't met Sally D'Angelo, here she is right here, by the way. She's just coming up to... Excuse me, just let me take a minute. Oh, where's my wife? She likes cookies. Throw the cookies into the slot. For all of Rocco's fans, he's done dancing, okay? I'm sure he'll be on TV someday. Okay, listen, a couple housekeeping things. First of all, they're making a DVD of the performances here this evening. Yes. If anyone would be interested in purchasing one of these, there's a place, I think, outside where you can put your name on a list, and I think they're only $120, $150. It's like Channel 2, you know? If you sign up to be a member of Channel 2 for $400, we'll send you this $4 disc. Okay. Which is a pirated copy. No. You're going to, you put your name on that list out there, and we'll make sure you get a DVD. May not be a disc, but it'll be a DVD. Secondly, one of the Auburn Youth and Family Service board members has a very important announcement to make about upcoming events, so I want to bring up Bob Moffitt, please. Bob has a couple things he'd like to say. He will not be dancing.
Thank you. But if you'd like to consider continue the celebration, and if you've had a good time tonight, we are going to have our annual dinner party and dance. It's going to be at Holy Cross College at the Hogan Center. That's March the 6th. It's a Saturday night. We'll have a full dinner. I just happen to have some tickets with me. We've kept the cost the same. It's $40 a person for a full meal. Rocco will be involved again. It's a relative of Rocco's that's doing the music for us. And we'll have an auction. We may try to even get an MC. But I will stay down in the where they're having the Chinese auction out while you're waiting for your cars. And have some tickets. You can sign up, take some tickets, and help us to support Auburn Youth and Family Services. Now I'll shut up so you can get back to the dance.
A word to the wise, those of you who have to rent tuxedos, come up. Do not get the leather thong. It is so hot and uncomfortable. Could have saved myself $5. In a half hour, figuring out how to put the thing on. And lay on the floor. Anyway, that's not in the DVD, all right? YouTube. Okay, let's get to the second half side of here. I'm getting emotionally drained. We're going to start the second half of the Charleston. Let me introduce you to Mr. Ray Butler. Don't be worried now, Ray. We've never met before. We haven't. No, okay. Now, Ray's originally from Alden, now lives in Sturbridge with his family. He has been working in Auburn the last several years, right? And has become very involved in Auburn activities, and obviously he's put a lot of time into getting ready to dance here tonight. Okay, so he's donating his Saturday evening to Auburn Youth and Family Services. Michelle, we've never met before. Well, you are a Holy Cross grad, I see, and so am I. So we have that in common. We both went to Holy Cross. Okay. No offense to anyone who went to BC. I'm sorry. I was thinking of Scott Brown and that Ayla or whatever. Anyways, and Michelle has been teaching in Worcester the last couple of years. Okay, and she's been dancing for like, I don't know, not 100, but maybe 15 to 16 years. It says 11 in the program, but I don't believe it. I think it's more than that. They're going to do a Charleston for you. Let me tell you right away, this is a difficult dance. This is a difficult one. Okay? They have been working very, very hard at this. Okay? So let's give them a big round of applause.
Thank you.
Yeah, me too. Me too. I walked all the way over here. So Ray, I read your little bio, and it says you like outdoor activities, motorcycling, all those nature things. Okay, how is this in comparison?
It was a little dangerous. A little nerve-wracking. But we made it. Thank you very much.
Okay, you're in good shape, though, aren't you? That oxygen still here? Paul Frost was originally going to do this dance. It's between he and I. Michelle, what do you think of your partner?
Oh, he was amazing.
I understand panting. Okay, nice job. Who's this guy? Who's that?
That's Obama.
It's hard to tell in this light, but I'll take your word for it. Let's see what the judges have to say. You can come closer. That's it, right there. Not too close. There's a certain space that should be here at all times. Fry, why don't we start with you? Because I know this has always been a challenging dance to you.
That's right. And I can tell I knew Ray had been practicing a lot because I saw him actually sewing ties like that on Route 1.
Kicks the lifts, tremendous energy. It was really fun to watch. A lot of enthusiasm. Thank you.
Guys, great chemistry. You obviously had a great time doing the dance, and you look fantastic.
You did good. You're in the top seven.
Well, the fringe dress was a must. That was a no-brainer. Yeah, absolutely. It showed off the dance perfectly. Your knee crosses and your heel slaps were right on. I think they were good.
Big round of applause for Justin. Okay. Now it's time to meet a fireman and a choreographer. Let's meet Chris Pierce and Carrie Callahan. Chris is he's hot. He's hot, man. Chris is a fireman out of Auburn. And paramedic. And disco dancer. You're reading his little bio, and I'm sure you've all read it, because it's little. And reading his bio, okay, as a fireman, he says he'd rather be going to a fire than dancing here this evening. Okay. That's how nervous he is. So, everyone line up. I can't do that. Okay, I guess I can. Carrie has been a dance instructor for 13 years at Sally McDermott. She's outstanding. I've seen her students perform. She's probably too young to even know what disco is, but I know that these two are really going to show it to you tonight. So let's have a little disco from... really, really good. Very good. I don't know if you noticed this, Chief, or not, but he was swinging his hips. He was looking right at you. He was even saying, "Don't worry, I got your back." Tonight. He just happened to have this hanging in the closet. Like Rocco did. Okay, let's have a few comments, first of all. What kind of an experience was this for you? You can hold this.
It was actually great. I've never done anything like this before, so it was, it was very good. Karen's a great teacher. Sally's a great teacher. And it was just a wonderful experience. It was great.
Carrie, what was it like training this guy? Or did it just come out of him, like, naturally? Because it looked like it was just flowing right out of him. Like he was stepping barefoot on hot coals. It was just like, it was so much energy.
It's very natural. I don't know if you've noticed, but this dance floor is on fire.
I feel it. Let's see what the judges have to say. I have to side at this end because of the camera, blocking the camera out there, and I guess they don't like my backside. I know you do. You're okay, man. Actually, I'm not like Howie Mandel, it's okay. Okay, Brian. Okay, Brian.
Well, Chief, now you know what goes on at the fire station.
I think I actually bought this for my wife.
Well, I think it's fair to say that disco is back. And Chris, I think you made it single-handedly. Put the white leisure suit, the big collar, the thick chain back in business.
He kept asking me if he could borrow my white coat. Now he goes, incredible grace, elegance. If you could bring some of that to work, I'd you guys, you're a contender. Definitely a contender.
Well, I really enjoyed your dance moves. Your footwork and your hands were in perfect sync with the music. That's exactly what disco's all about. And you did a great job for portraying that. I really enjoyed it.
Big round of applause. You okay over here? Okay. From disco, we're gonna move up or down, era-wise. Okay. We're gonna do the swing now. Chris Hugo, who was the choreographer behind this particular swing dance. Chris has a degree in marine biology, and it served him well because he now runs a TV channel in Auburn. But the most interesting thing in reading the bio here is his interests, and I think it's awesome. This is a guy who really, really enjoys life. I'm going to read it to you in case you haven't read it or you forgot your glasses at home. I forgot my glasses at home. Chris enjoys the swing dance. It's one of his favorites. He likes to tango. He likes wreck diving, shack diving, and rollerblading. I read that because it turns out that Doreen likes all of the same things. Shack diving is one of her favorites. Right up there, right up there. I mean, Doreen Goodrich. Obviously a very popular young lady in town. Two things impressed me about reading her bio. One is how family oriented she is. Phenomenally family oriented. Which is perfect for tonight's event, Auburn Youth and Family Services. Family is very, very important to her. The other thing that's important to her is that she loves to cook. And she doesn't care whether it's for two or 200. Tonight at 11 o'clock at Doreen's house, you are all invited. You're all invited for a little after dinner snack, okay? Nothing big, lobster. Steak. You're gonna do the swing. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, self-choreographed by Hugo and his shock diving friend. They're ready to go. Let's see them.
Thank you.
Second. A beer. Come on over here for a minute. All the animals are inside, going in. Okay. That was outstanding. Outstanding. What?
He has any oxygen.
He does, but he's keeping it for himself right now. That was tremendous. I love those slow dances. That was excellent. I couldn't tell who the instructor was, who the choreographer was, and who the student was. Okay, Dorian. You ready? What do you think, man? Cheryl?
I think I want to keep doing it.
That's awesome. That's awesome to hear. Not tonight, Dorian, okay? You did it right there. You're there, okay? Chris, what was it like working with Dorian?
Oh, she was great. She picked it up right away. We didn't have a lot of time to practice, but... she's a natural.
Great couple. Let's see what the judges have to say. You are okay. You want some more water or anything like that? Okay. Brian, we're going to start with you again. You ready? I know, another big dance for you.
That was outstanding. Fancy, fancy footwork. Great, great job. Can't wait to see the next lesson. Sutton.
That was really hot. I'm so amazed watching with all the kicks and the twirls and everything. Excellent. Really fun to watch.
Very few women in this room would be comfortable twirling. Awesome.
Absolutely unbelievable. I want to know, hey Chris, I gotta ask you, does that suit attract a lot of bumblebees?
It just screams caution to my followers.
Now we'll go to our dance expert.
Well, you put some very complicated steps together and you really did them well, and I was very impressed. Thank you.
Another big round of applause for Chris. Outstanding job. Thank you, have some flowers.
That was good.
So impressed with all of the dances tonight. Really, it's been outstanding. Outstanding. We have now come to the final number for this evening. And I gotta tell you, the judges are gonna have a hard time. I want to introduce Joe Buzz Martin, right? And Caitlin Foley. Caitlin Foley. They're going to be doing a musical theater number for you, right? Okay. Joe has been in Auburn working for 22 years. He's the executive director of Packagog Acres, and he has obviously been involved in numerous other activities throughout the time. So it's okay. They're still cheering for that. I can't believe it. Caitlin, former Auburn High grad, been teaching with Sally now for 15 years. Choreographing. She's been to college since I last saw her, graduated from college. She's graduated from graduate school out of Anna Maria. She has two kids. She has a husband. She has a husband and two kids. I don't want to embarrass her before she starts here. Ladies and gentlemen, the final act of the night, Joan Cableman.
As far as I'm going with that.
Okay, Mary Ellen.
Perfect way to end the night. A powerhouse performance. Lots of fun. Thank you.
I was going to say that I'd like to borrow the hairpiece, but now I'm not so sure.
And still the back. I'm sorry, that's my wife. I'm sorry.
Definitely the bar has been raised in this, on this conversation.
Absolutely. It was a combination of the different dances, and that was kind of interesting and unusual, and I really enjoyed it. You put great energy into it. Thank you.
Big round of applause for Bailey and Joe. Okay, now, this is what's going to happen. What's going to happen right now is that the judges are going to confer right there. I guess, right? Right there, you're going to make your decision, do what you got to do. We can't listen in. Before we bring Sally up, I have a couple things that I have to do, a couple more house cleaning things. But I want to let you know, or make you aware of some of the people who have volunteered to make this night successful. Okay. So I'm just going to read some names, and if you know these people, you give them a pat on the back and you thank them for all the work they've done. These are volunteers. Van Stackangelo, Jay Foley, Ryan Gow, Maureen Kennedy, Lisa Ledger, Rose Ledger, Megan McDermott, Jody Nipkaczynski, Rich Nordstrom, Don Nugent, Roger Nugent, Sam Pacelli, Eric Spafford, Lori Thornton, Ashley Williams, and Elaine Zotten. Big round of applause. Then we have some businesses that that have contributed either time, money, people, or supplies to this event that you should be thanking also. First of all, Atlas Distributing, Bernardi's Formal Wear, Dave Paradise, Gerton's Trophy, Kim Lavelli, Masterman's, S&K Valet Service, who have now recently removed all your hubcaps. Taylor Rental, Vance and Sally D'Angelo, Sally McDermott Dance Center, Piccadilly Pub of Auburn, Marsh Kemp Insurance Agency, J.E. Mullaly Package Store, Dick and Bob of Granger, Curry Printing of Worcester, Auburn Community Television, and Anne-Marie Wisalco. Big round of applause for all of us. And now, it's my job to MC, but it's not my job to present the award, because my role in this whole evening has been very small compared to the individual I'm going to introduce to you right now. Tonight would not have happened if not for Sally McDermott, Sally Heaney, and for the Sally I'm going to introduce to you right now. A big round of applause for Sally D'Angelo. The reason this thing is so successful.
I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. This couldn't have happened without all of you being here too. And there was a whole bunch of people. Nothing happens with just one person. It happens with everybody working together. And I thank so much for the behind the scenes detail that has happened to put this event together. I'd like to thank our MC for the evening, Mr. Joe. We have a little gift for you. Yes, a gift certificate to go to Outback Steakhouse, but you have to take your wife and not leave her in the car. Mr. Joe Worley. know if you knew this, but we actually have dancing after this event is all over. And we received free DJ service from Mr. Paul LaRoche. I'd like to ask two very special people that this event couldn't happen without to come forward. Helene Hannum, who you met earlier. Ballroom dances with Helene next, so if anyone wants ballroom lessons, this is the lady.
What disco?
A disco.
What about swing?
Swing? Swing lessons?
Chris
Hugo, where are you? Thank you, Helene, for all your hard work and your dedication. We couldn't have done this without you. And about 10 years ago, when my daughter was 3, she went to her first dance class at Sally McDermott Dance Center, and she has fallen in love ever since. And it's because of the beautiful lady that's standing up here today, and also the beautiful teacher, so great role model. So I got to know Sally as a parent bringing a student. Recently, we've been working day and night together, as Rocco calls us, Sally Squared. And I would like to apologize to John Heaney if he's around here anywhere. Where are you, John? Mr. John Heaney, Sally's husband. Who hasn't been seeing too much of Sally lately, because she's been working on Auburn's Dancing with the Stars. Seriously, it couldn't have happened without Sally loaning us her beautiful facility, her beautiful dancers, her beautiful volunteers. She has a very great work ethic, and she's dedicated and caring and loving, and I just don't know what we've done without you. Thank you. And tomorrow, when you kick off your shoes, I forgot, I left one thing in the box back there. We have bought you your special wine that you enjoy, so you can have a glass of your special wine, which is Behringer White Zinfandel. Thank you. And a gift certificate to your favorite salon. So I'm getting you in this audience tonight. A dancing bear, because you are born a star. And the children and families of Auburn Youth and Family Services have made you a thank you card. Dear Sally, thank you for making Auburn's Dancing with the Soft Stars a huge success. Love all the kids. There you go. Okay, now I'm going to turn the microphone over to Mr. Joe Hurley to get the dancers back.
I think before I do that, however, we have payback. So I'm going to let the two politicians take the floor for about a half an hour. We'll filibuster them.
Now, I was very short in my statement before. all the dancers just wanted to recognize Sally D'Angelo for thinking of this idea and all the hard work she's doing for the youth in Auburn. It's a great program. We're very happy to be here on her behalf. So we bought some flowers for her for breakfast tonight. and also for volunteering her time, teaching us dance steps tonight. And it was a lot of hard work and stress on her behalf in volunteering the studio tonight. We wanted to also call some flowers for Sally McDermott. Is that quick enough for you?
Big round of applause for these ladies right here. I would like you all now to give a big round of applause for all of the dancers as we bring them back out. You may stand. Great work. I want you to understand that there are absolutely no losers tonight. You're all winners. Everyone. The biggest winners are Auburn Youth and Family Services. The number of people that will be helped by your volunteering here tonight and your presence here tonight is tremendous. And just a small little personal note that I want to make is a non-political statement is that so often all around the world, things are going poorly for so many people that we sometimes forget that it's not going so great for the people who are closest to us, the people who are really, really around us. And this event is going to help a lot of people who go unrecognized by newspapers and media and politics. So you guys did a good thing tonight. Really good stuff. Do we have a winner? I'll take that as a yes. Sally.
It is my pleasure to announce the 2010 winner of the Auburn Dancing with the Stars, Chris Hugo and Lori.
Another one big round of applause for the dancers.